Hey everyone, this is Revanth from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 239. Siddharth Mandala has invented rape prevention electronic shoes that would give an electric shocks to the rapist while sending an alert to cops and family members. These shoes are recharged automatically during walking. Government of India currently working on drawing up legislation for the cryptocurrencies in India. It is likely that crypto will be categorized as an asset rather than a currency. This bill will be presented in front of the cabinet in the upcoming winter sessions. Apple will finally allow customers to repair their iPhones at home. The company will sell parts, tools, and instructions on how to repair Apple products at home without any service center supervision. iPhone 12 and iPhone 13 will be the first product to get DIY repairs, followed by M1 powered MacBooks. Apple seems to be gearing up to open its first retail store in India. The Cupertino tech giant had launched its online store just last year in the country. We have been hearing rumors about the Apple's retail store in India for a few years now. But it was confirmed officially in 2020 last year. The company's CEO, Tim Cook, confirmed that the company is seeking approval from the government and plans to open its retail store in 2021 in India. Now Apple has started hiring employees for its upcoming offline retail store in India. According to the LinkedIn post, the recruiter also confirmed that the first two Apple retail stores will be opening in Mumbai and Delhi locations. Apple is looking to hire employees for various roles including store leader, operation experts, senior manager, manager, market leader and many more. However, we can expect these stores to go live in early 2022 if not in 2021. Instagram Badges has now officially started rolling out. These features allow creators to earn money from their followers. Badges allows users to show support for creators during a live video on the platform. Starting Wednesday, users aged 18 and above with more than 10,000 followers in selected regions will be able to use Instagram Badges. Once purchased, the badges will appear alongside comments during a live cast. These features will let creators engage with supporters, and the host of the live video can see a list of supporters and badges purchased during the live stream for up to 90 days. It looks like Instagram is getting quite active in terms of adding new features and fixes in its application. A couple of days ago, it was found out that Instagram is planning to introduce a subscription service for exclusive content. Today, Instagram has announced that it has started testing its ability for people to add music to their posts they shared on their feed. An official statement from Instagram said that a music plays an instrumental role in enabling people to share, connect, and express themselves on Instagram. With this test, Instagram hopes to give its community a way to add a soundtrack to their feed photos like they can do with Reels and Stories already. Microsoft latest Surface Go 3 laptop, which also doubles as a tablet, has been unveiled for the Indian market. This gadget arrives with a starting price of ₹42,999, that is around $579. This is coming nearly 2 months after the 2-in-1 laptop was released for the global audience. Ola Lottery cracks a deal with the Embassy of the Netherlands in India. The company will deliver 9 Ola S1 scooters to the institution, which will then be used for diplomatic missions. These scooters will sport a custom orange shade and a Netherlands logo. The Realme GT Master Edition launched a little while ago in India. A new daybreak blue color variant of the smartphone is tipped to launch soon in the country. Alongside that, we can also expect to see memory variant of this new color variant that will be coming in. The Realme Narzo lineup could also include another model called as the Realme Narzo 50A Prime. This handset will join the existing Narzo 50A and Narzo 50i series. The company could also launch a new C-series phone called as the Realme C35. Realme Watch 2 will soon get a new color variant in India. We have exclusive information suggesting the launch of a special gold color variant of the watch. The launch is likely to happen by month end or in December. The Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition 5G is expected to launch in January 2022. This phone will come with a Snapdragon 888 chipset, a 6.4-inch Full HD Plus AMOLED display and a plastic body. This device should be available with up to 12GB of RAM and a 256GB of internal storage. With the significant improvements of the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 over its predecessor, the Korean tech giant is looking to make its upcoming Galaxy Z Fold 4 even more appealing to premium customers. Samsung is gearing up to launch their next generation Fold 4 around quarter 3 in 2022 with an improved under-display camera on both internal and external screens. The overall primary camera setup is also getting an upgrade to bring the Galaxy Z Fold 4 on par with the camera quality offered by the current flagship in the market. The Fold 4 may also get a new hing which might reduce weight. The new hing will also bring improved water resistance and a dust resistance certification that was previously absent with the Galaxy Z Fold lineup. Xiaomi planning on launching more devices than expected. Other than the Redmi Note 11T 5G launch, Xiaomi will also introduce Xiaomi 11i and Xiaomi 11i Hypercharge in India. Both these devices are expected to be a rebranded version of Redmi Note 11 Pro and Redmi Note 11 Pro Plus. Moto Edge X and Moto Edge S30 has recently spotted on the TINA certification website. On Antutu, the Moto Edge S30 scored around 858,000 points. The Moto Edge S30 could launch in the global market with the Moto G200. The dual camera Vivo Y76s 5G arrived last week. And now we hear the vanilla version is also right around the corner. This phone will be called as Vivo Y76 5G and will come with 3 cameras on November 23rd. The launch will take place online and will be live streamed by Vivo Malaysia on its social media channels. A seller on Amazon sells a Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra bought under Flipkart's Smart Upgrade Plan. The customer bought this smartphone in November 2021 for ₹57,499 from seller Divine India on Amazon. Now Flipkart has warned the customer to block the smartphone due to non-payment of the remaining amount. The BGMI team has permanently banned over 25 lakhs accounts and temporarily banned over 7 lakhs accounts for cheating. All these accounts were banned in just over a month. The development team has revealed how it is taking stronger efforts to reduce the instances of cheating in BGMI. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.